Imagining the Earth as one interconnected totality is the result of a technological vision that accompanied modernity. This planetary totalization is now enhanced by a multitude of networking systems that unify otherwise separate environments into totalitarian violence on a global scale. The city has been the model for the organization of political life. The polis, with its urban setting, has become our cosmic scenario. But the desertification of fertile soil and the desolation of human environments changed our political imagination. Houses increasingly resemble bunkers. Farms are becoming utopian eco-fortresses, ultimate shelters immersed in an imaginary of collapse and permanent state of emergency. Nevertheless, the multiplicity of planetary compositions shows that life always has the capacity of organizing itself without confining itself. If power nowadays appears to be technically distributed within diffuse networks, resistance too becomes disseminated. In this situation, every transmission channel, every hub, every plantation overflown by reconnaissance drones, every platform for information exchange can suddenly become the agent of an imminent planetary insurrection.
We have learned this year something about segregation. We might have known it all the way along, but we unmistakably know it now. Segregation is a political illusion and a waste of energy because our biological continuity doesn't disappear by excluding people. The human community is a fact, and if we wanted evidence of it, now we have it. The virus brought it along. Viruses travel through the bodies like power relationships, and airborne ones travel through the air that we all must breathe. The guard, who breathes the same prison air as the convicts, us, who sit next to him in the public transportation, our children, who sit in school together, we all breathe the same air. The physical distance that we've had to regulate is usually bearable, dynamic, and we have realized how restrictive 2 meters can be, how often we get closer to each other to distance ourselves again. Social distancing, enabled by emotional distancing, worked like a symptom displaced by hypnosis. It has shown hierarchy as an arbitrary violence. Every distance that we can't modify diminishes our forces, reduces our power. Reproducing our forces, now drained by the technological apparatus that preserves separation and that you're using to listen to me, will be the most important task, the most renewable energy that will take us through the future is our social energy. The love force, the struggle force, the hope force, the one that our interactions only will reproduce. This will get us through the current darkness and disaster. And this will show production as function of reproduction and women as producers of the producers. This will revolutionize our approach to what capitalism has shown us as real. It is indeed an unreal reality that puts a price on life if it were an object and not an energy. We need a magic materialism to show us, as Benjamin said, what in surrealism, the impenetrable as the everyday and the everyday as impenetrable.